So I've talked a lot in the past about using dictation on your Mac to make it easier to type things. But you can also use dictation to control your Mac. And in combination with typing things, you can have a pretty hands-free experience. So for instance, let's go into System Preferences and make sure dictation is turned on. So that's under Keyboard and then Dictation. And then you want to have it turned on, and you also want to turn on Use Enhanced Dictation. This makes dictation local on your Mac instead of sending it into Apple servers and back like Siri does. Besides that, check to see what your shortcut is. I have it set to the default of using the FN key twice, but you could set it to something else if you like. Otherwise, you don't really need to turn on anything special. There's some more settings inside of accessibility, but just using these default settings, you can control your Mac as well as type dictation. So as an example, let's send an email without using the keyboard. So I'm here in the Mail app, and I'm going to trigger dictation using the FN key. And then I'm going to compose a new message and send it without touching either the mouse or the keyboard. But before I begin, let's take a look at the list of commands, because this is going to be very useful for learning all this stuff. Eventually you may not need it, but at the beginning you definitely are going to need it to be able to refer to until you get the hang of things. The easiest way to bring up the list of commands is to use the dictation feature itself, just with the term Show Commands. So I'm going to hit the FN key twice and then say Show Commands. Show Commands. And as you can see, this brings up this list of dictation commands, and the list is specific to what application I have running. So it's got a bunch of things, anything it accepts right now. So if I look under Application, I could see all the things I can do now, including choosing menus. So I should be able to say a phrase, starting with the word click here, and then using the different menu commands and start a new message and go from there. I'm going to refer to this list very carefully as I go so I can make sure I'm doing the right thing. And eventually I'll get the hang of it and won't need this anymore. So let's start by creating a new message and then filling out the fields and then sending the message. Click File menu. Choose one. Joe. Next field. Next field. Next field. This is a test message. Next field. Hello, Joe, period. This is a test message, period. Click Send. And there you go. I've sent a message using only my voice. Notice how I looked up commands here to see what was available. So when it was time for me to send the message, I noticed that I could say the word click, and it allowed me to choose from a list here of buttons that it found in the interface. And one of them was the Send button, which isn't available now because I'm not in the Compose window. But I was able to quickly send that. And the easiest way I found for moving between the To field and, you know, down to the Subject field and down to the Body was using the Next field command, which I found in here as well. And for typing the email address, the only real good way I found to do it was to use something in my address book and use the name. And it kind of looked it up. So I could have spelled out more of the name. You notice there were two options there, but it was the first option that I was using in the test. So there was a lot of different things there, and it was very specific to what I was doing for sending an email message. For doing a task you may need to do without touching the keyboard or the mouse, you're going to have to look through these different commands here and see how they change as you go to different stages of what you're trying to do. And try different things. For instance, it took me a lot of trial and error to go to find this Go to Next Field section here, you know, and use that and find that that was the best way to move on through the different little fields there to get to the different parts of sending the message. But there may be other ways, selecting menu items, using the click command here like this, to do what you need to do in whatever app it is that you're working in. But I encourage you to play around with this and experiment and try different things. See what's possible. Not everything is going to be possible. And it may be that the easiest way to do some things is to actually to type a key or click something with your mouse every once in a while. So it's about finding a balance between which is easiest to use and how often you're willing to actually touch your mouse or keyboard while doing these tasks.